I suppose in some way you have learned that I do tricks of magic, and so, through curiosity, you have come here. You may have been told that I do not injure anyone, so you are bold enough to disobey my commands to go away. You imagine that you may witness some of the rites of witchcraft, and that they may amuse you. Have I spoken truly?" "Well," remarked Ervic, who had been pondering on the strange circumstance of his coming here, "you are right in some ways, but not in others. I am told that you work magic only for your own amusement. That seems to me very selfish. Few people understand magic. I'm told that you are the only real Yookoohoo in all Oz. Why don't you amuse others as well as yourself?" "What right have you to question my actions?"
"None at all."
"And you say you are not here to demand any favors of me?"
"For myself, I want nothing from you."
"You are wise in that. I never grant favors."
"That doesn't worry me," declared Ervic.
"But are you curious? You hope to witness some of my magic transformations?"
"If you wish to perform any magic, go ahead," said Ervic. "It may interest me, and it may not. If you'd rather go on with your knitting, it's all the same to me. I am in no hurry at all." This may have puzzled Red Rira, but the face beneath the lace cap could show no expression, being covered with hair. Perhaps in all her career the Yookoohoo had never been visited by anyone who, like this young man, asked for nothing, expected nothing, and had no reason for coming except curiosity. This attitude practically disarmed the witch, and she began to regard the Skeezer in a more friendly way.